It's the Montreal Just for Laughs Comedy Festival. Kevin Hart presents LOL at JFL.
Oh, man. I think that it's great to have orgasms. Anybody with me? Yes. Yes. I think orgasms are important in life because it's good for you spiritually, physically, and mentally, okay? I think we should have an orgasm every day, wake up, have an OJ and an O. That's what I'm suggesting. I think your resume should have how many orgasms you've had in life. That's all I'm saying. But orgasms are very different for men and women, right? Like, for guys, it's much easier to have an orgasm. You're having one right now. It's easier to have them. And for women, it's a little bit more difficult. You have to put more work into it, okay, guys? You have to put more work in it. And I'm not talking about, like, working it in bed. I'm talking about the lead-up, okay? You have to take us out for, a meal, all right? We are hungry. We are always hungry. Take us out for food first. Get us some wine, right? Take us home, maybe put on some nice music, put candles out, give us a sensual massage. So we can start to imagine, you know what I mean? Get in that mood, imagine that we are with someone else. I'm a single lady, I'm having like a real sexual revolution right now, okay? Thank you, Mom. And it's a great time, it's a really great time. And I decided the other day that I was going to become a dirty talker in bed, all right? Just talking dirty, giving them what they want. No one's asked for it. Okay, but here's the thing. And I was like, okay, I come from like an athlete background. So I'm like, you gotta practice this, you gotta mentally train to get ready for this, right? So I'm sitting at home and I'm really like, I'm taking this very seriously. I'm looking at myself in the mirror like, okay, we're gonna be a dirty talker now. That's our thing, we're dirty talkers now, you know? And so I'm looking in the mirror like, okay, practice your lines, get ready for it. What do guys like to think about? Like, I don't know, sports stats, you know? And I finally started dating this guy and everything was going well and it became that moment where we were like, we're gonna go home, we're gonna do the sexy time. And I was ready. I woke up in the morning, I started stretching, getting ready, getting nimble. Like, talk to myself, like, you got this, you know? And we came to that moment, and I was on top of him, I was riding him, right? I'm like, okay, you're a free, beautiful bird. You're just gonna fly all over this, gonna do this. And I looked at him, and I was like, yeah, okay. Mama likes. And he was into it, you know? So he's like, oh, okay. So he gave me a little spank on the butt, right? I'm like, okay, yeah, we got this. Up at a level, you know? I'm like, yeah. Give mama more what she likes. And I'm thinking in my head, killing it, you know? And so we kept going, it kept getting more, like we were just both so into it. And then I locked eyes with him and just looked at him in the face and went, yeah, punish me. And then the sex finished and I was literally high-fiving myself when he went to the bathroom to clean up. I'm like, great job, great first game of the season. And, he came back, though, and he was like, okay, well, that was fun, first time, oh, you know? And then he went, just one question for you, though. Did you at some point ask me to punch you? I was like, what? No, I said, punish me, right? And the theme of what was happening, some spanks and stuff. And he's like, oh, no, I thought that you said, punch me. And I was like, oh, we laughed a lot about it. But I thought, can you imagine if he didn't stop to clarify in his own head? Like, I'm riding him, looking very intensely, like, yeah, mama likes, punish me. And he's just like, boom, you know? Mama wants this? Like, I don't know. And then I thought about it a little more, and I thought, what a you know? When your woman asks for something in bed, you give it to her, you do not hesitate. Yeah, I like sex. I like orgasms. I think that all women should have vibrators as well because you have to know how to please yourself if you want someone to please you. You know what I'm saying? Who's got vibrators here? Huh? Sir? Yeah? Anybody? I think every woman should have a vibrator, okay? You should just, it's beautiful. And I don't like when guys are jealous of women's sex toys. And I understand because if you're a guy and you have a sex toy, you're a psycho, okay? Like a f***ing a what? You know, like, you know. But if you're jealous of a woman with a sex toy, you're a crazy person because we're not getting sex toys that emulate your stuff. We're not comparing it directly to your stuff because that is gross. Have you looked down at your own stuff lately, men? Just flipping and flopping out there? No, we don't care. It's not like, and here's the thing. My vibrator is purple. and it has a beaver with its tongue sticking out, okay? Very Canadian. But I'm hoping that your junk looks nothing like that when I bring your pants down. And here's the thing, I was doing this joke one time and a guy stood up in the audience, okay, stood up and he went, no, 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 no. If you go home with me, you don't need a vibrator. I was like, seriously, dude? Okay. Unless your only move in the bedroom is just na 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 na. You know what I mean? Then I also need a vibrator. That's all I'm saying. You guys are awesome. I'm Aisha Alfa. Thank you.